I spent the last 30 days executing a plan, a master plan, to become hyper-focused, high-performing, effective, enduring individual, and take back my life from the Matrix. This week is packed with discovery and insight. Enjoy. Alright, the last week. And this time we got some momentum, because on week 3 I managed to hit every single day with my deep work habit list. Will I be able to keep up this energy? I don't know.
Day 22, super slow start today.
Here in my garage, my Ferrari. So it's the first day of the fourth week and I'm off to work now. I'm ready for the day actually, I'm ready for the week. So we're instantly going to a client to shoot some videos and get that service done. We finished our meeting and we finished our shoot. Now we still got some office work to do.
Tough time.
So a very successful day up till now, very, very focused.
Yeah, and later we go and have a look to our location where we shoot at Saturday.
Video. We got a bigger shoot on Saturday, so we're planning for that. Another long day. It's worth it in the end. No effort is wasted, it always pays you back in some way.
Day 23.
What I meant by that is, even if you spend all your energy so that you feel completely exhausted and the results don't line up in the end, you still learn something and you can walk away with a new lesson that might help you in the future, maybe not. Then at least it molded your character and ends as a story. Anyway, we spent a part of the morning gathering supplies for the office. All right, now we're off to get some actual food at an actual store. What I've been noticing looking back on these days is that all this utter fluff, the routines don't really matter to get the work done. What gets the work done is showing up even if you don't get your 8 hours of sleep, turning off distractions and simply getting the work done. Almost 11 o'clock and I'm eating breakfast. Nevertheless, it's gonna be a busy day today, but just a bit shorter than usual. Those are my supplements for the day, D3 and K2, just to get through the winter. You know how it is. Now, that being said, we are in it for the long run. Think strategic. Having good health is worth the time sacrifice, and it will pay off in the long run. So I went for a calisthenics workout. Drip too hard, don't stand too close. You gon' fuck around and drown. Off this way, doing all these shows. I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, long as I get paid. Bad little fire, she been on my mind. Soon as I get back, she can stay. Do this all the time, this ain't no surprise. Every other night, another movie get made. Drip too hard, don't stand too close. You gon' fuck around and drown. Off this way, doing all these shows. I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, long as I get paid. Alright, that's a wrap. Short but intense workout done. I'm super pumped right now. Feels good. Today was a very unproductive day in total. I got up too late. I worked a little. I didn't do much. And then in the evening, I was gone early and I spent most of my evening in a good way. I spent it with my brother. I spent it with a friend. But nevertheless, not productive. I'm not gonna let this hinder my growth. And I'm just gonna keep pushing tomorrow. So even though it's very late already, I'm gonna get up early tomorrow and push through for a good day. Day 25. So the past half an hour I spent working on the intro, and now I'm gonna go to Zug, the city close by to my hometown, and I'm gonna head out to a big open workspace now to meet a friend. Off to an open workspace. Some people like to imitate the cafe feeling with the Spotify playlist. I rather just go there in real life. It was a very good session here.
working here with the boys. It's fun. We're gonna come here tomorrow again because it's just an amazing space here. I love working here. Here I work better, I work more. Just benefits of leaving home, basically.
I feel absolutely amazing today. I feel like change is happening. I feel like I'm slowly becoming a different person, a better version of myself, and I'm happy for that. These 3 to 4 weeks are finally paying off slowly. The seeds that I was watering are starting to grow.
It's 20 past midnight on Saturday, so it's basically Sunday. I just spent the whole afternoon shooting one commercial campaign for ourselves, for our company, and I'm roasted, man. Completely exhausted. I need to sleep, man.
It's the last day of the week. It's a Sunday. I'm pretty much just recovering, resting, and taking time for myself today. But I feel like I want to do some work today. I don't feel the need to do work, but I kind of want to do work because I enjoy it, so I'll jump on the laptop later. Before that, I'm going for a workout with my friends, like each Sunday, so I'm gonna take you along.
Working out is absolutely fundamental for me. It has been one of those keystone habits that everything else builds upon. I do calisthenics because it is extremely cost-effective, also known as free, and I enjoy being outside while getting stronger and spending time with friends. A win-win-win-win-win-win situation.
The past weeks have been quite crazy. Time has gone by so fast. I haven't really missed many work days now. At the start I was struggling, and now I'm completely killing it, almost going overboard. Yeah, you should see my habit list. I completely missed all of my nighttime routines, like for the past 1.5 to 2 weeks, but I killed it and I worked every day. I worked every day except for Sundays usually, so I was completely killing it the past 2 weeks. I'm tired.
It's the last day of the challenge. Exactly why I work out in the evening. Today is gonna be a tough day. When I work out in the morning, I'm so tired all day long.
This recap that you're seeing right now is about 3 weeks after the last day of my challenge. And I thought this would be useful in a way, because 30 days is a very, very short time to capture change and let it grow and let it sit. So I decided that by recording the last words of the video, basically in a delayed time frame, so 2-3 weeks after the challenge, will give a more accurate view of what actually happened. I would say a more objective view on the changes, because I'm not in the chaos, not in the fire anymore. It's kind of an abrupt stop to this whole series because I don't have anything to show except for a few crosses on my list and the videos that you saw over the past 4 weeks. I don't have a skill that I've learned that I can show you, like a handstand or solving the Rubik's Cube. I'm basically just the product myself and some of the wisdom or nuggets that I think I've learned over the 30 days. And I would like to share those with you because there's not much more to it. I can't really go any deeper. Am I hyper-focused after these 30 days or even the 3 weeks that I've attached now to it? I would say most definitely not hyper-focused. I still struggle with distractions. I still waste a lot of time. But when I do focus 2.5 hours straight hyper-focused, project just finished itself. And that's an amazing feeling. Generally, I think that change takes a long time to happen.
generally it's a good thing because you can actually let the right things grow and you can weed out all the small seeds and saplings that are growing with all the effort or the watering that you're doing. And the garden is a metaphor. Giving myself 30 days was a good idea. Is it enough? Hell no. Am I trying to combat things that have been habits now for over years? Yes, so it was a very good start. It was a very effective start. It was a tough start. And as you saw in the first 2 weeks, I kind of was struggling and then I finally caught some momentum. And now 3 weeks later, I still have that momentum. So it was worth it in the end. But I definitely haven't changed like a massive amount yet. 30 days is just not enough time. You won't change that much in 30 days. And that's okay. So just take a step back, relax, breathe, and enjoy. I feel like I'm talking straight to myself.